The Bible says, for it became him, for whom are all things, and by whom are all things, in bringing many sons into glory, to make the captain of their salvation perfect through suffering. For both he that sanctifieth and they who are sanctified are all of one. For which cause he is not ashamed to call them brethren. So you are brother of Jesus. You are sister of Jesus. There is no better relationship. If you have not accepted Jesus into your life, then you are not in the family of God. If you have not received him into your life as your Lord and Savior, the starting point is receiving Jesus into your life today. Because you see, the relationship between you and your brother and your sister may not work if you don't have relationship with God. The Bible says love covereth multitude of sin. I can imagine there was another relationship that I mentioned. And you can look at this in the Bible. The relationship between Joseph and his brothers, it was that of envy. Amen. You see, like I was saying earlier on, when Joseph had a dream, go and read Genesis 37. He didn't first share with his father. His mother was late then. It was his brethren, the Bible says. In verse 4 or so, she said, the Bible says, and he had a dream, and then he shared it with his brothers. In verse 11, he shared it with his brothers. Like I told you, your children will first share it with each other before they share it with you. So as parents, it's important for you also to make sure that they get along. They can fall out and they will get together. Don't take anybody's side. Let them bond. Let them be children. Praise the name of the Lord. So what I'm saying here is that you have an elder brother. Jesus is your elder brother. If you have Jesus, then you have the counselor. Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6. He becomes your counselor. So when you are in a fix and you don't know what to do, you can call upon Jesus. He cares for you. 1 Peter 5, 7. He cares. He said, casting all your cares upon him, for he careth for you. He cares about you. He protects you. If you look at the book of Psalm 91, it's talking about protection. Verses 9 to 11. So this Jesus, if he's your elder brother, if Miriam can do so much for Moses, Jesus will do much more for you. Amen?
Amen.
If Miriam can go to that land to protect a little brother, I can't imagine what Jesus will not do for you. In fact, he paid the supreme price by offering himself for you. I told you, Miriam risked her life, but Jesus gave his life for his brothers and sisters. There's no better relationship than that of Jesus. And when your foundation is on Jesus, your relationship with your brothers and sisters will be in place. When you have one or two of them that have not got to know Jesus, it is your responsibility to pray for them until they know Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. Now I want you to please rise on your feet. As we take ourselves to God, like I said, every relationship is important, and every relationship is ordained by God. There is a reason why God has given you that sister, you may not like her. There is a reason why God has given you that brother, you may not enjoy your relationship with her. But if you can open your mind today, that may be the Miriam in your life. That may be the Moses in your life. So I want you to thank God for every relationship in your life. Thank God for your brothers, if you have. Thank God for your sisters, if you have. Thank God for your parents, if you have. Thank God for your cousins, if you have. Thank God for your nephews, if you have. Thank God for your nieces, if you have. Thank God for everyone that is connected to you, if you have anybody like that in your life. Just say, Lord, I want to thank you for these people you have positioned in my life. Thank you for all that you have used them to accomplish in the past. And thank you, Lord God Almighty, for what you will use them to do in the future. To you be glory and praise. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
I want you to pray one prayer. And it is Father,
Father,
the purpose for which you have put my siblings in my life, let it be accomplished. Just pray that prayer. Your brother, your sister, anyone that is related to you, the reason why you have put them in my life, let it be accomplished. Without a Moses, there could be no Miriam. Without Miriam, possibly we would not have heard of Moses. If God has put them in your life for a reason, that is the power of relationship. When they are there, and they are there for a purpose, and until that purpose is fulfilled, they are just there. So pray that the Lord will help them to accomplish the purpose for which He has put them in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, I will not miss it, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Father, the reason why you have put me in the life of my sister, Father, shall be fulfilled. And the reason why you have put her in my life shall be fully accomplished. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we are grateful. Thank you for all these relationships. Thank you for everyone in our lives. Thank you because they are special to you and they are special to us. We appreciate you for these relationships. Glory and honor to your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Father, our prayer this hour is that we don't want to take any of our relationships for granted, because there is a reason why you have put people in our lives. You don't want us to be alone in life, and we are grateful for all these ones. Father, our prayer is that the reason why you have put these people in our lives shall be accomplished in the mighty name of Jesus. If we have done anything and we have fallen out with any of these loved ones, Father, you are God that is, you want us to be reconciled. Father, we pray, oh God, that the grace to reconcile one with another, you give unto us in the mighty name of Jesus. Everyone we need to forgive, give us the grace to forgive them and move on in the mighty name of Jesus. Let there be healings in homes. Let there be healings in families. Let there be healings among siblings. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And for every one of us that have fallen out with you, Father, bring us back to you today. In the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus, our elder brother. From now on, we want to know that we have a back. We have somebody that has our back. We have Jesus, a big brother that is always interested in us, that is ready to protect us, that can give anything for us. Help us to be aware of this, even in our daily dealings, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. We praise and we worship you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Somebody shout a big amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Please sit down as we are bringing this service.